6,100 megabytes per second reads versus 5,700 megabytes per second reads. Oh my lord, that's amazing. Are you on the hunt for the best external SSD for your Mac or PC? With so many fancy USB and Thunderbolt options out there, it can be tough to know which one to pick. But fear not, I've got you covered and can help you save some serious cash while making the smartest choice. Let's dive in. Hi, I'm Teresa from MORGONAUT.com and I specialize on one-on-one coaching and remote help to individuals as well as audio and video production houses all around the globe. So if you would need any help with your Apple Mac, Windows, Linux, servers, DaVinci Resolve and more, then you can in few clicks schedule a Zoom video meeting with me and a remote session to your computer so I can help you right in front of your eyes. The latest higher-end Macs have Thunderbolt 5, while the base M4 Macs have only Thunderbolt 4. But all of them have multiple USB-C ports on the back and on the front. Thunderbolt 5 is better than Thunderbolt 4, and that is better than just USB 4, right? Not so easy. To be clear, Thunderbolt 5 outperforms USB 4 in many technical aspects on paper, up to 120 gigabits per second and 80 gigabits bidirectional standard, simultaneous high-speed storage plus display, you can daisy chain and so on. But that's more likely useful for Thunderbolt docks rather than for just an external SSD disk. I never saw Thunderbolt external disk with second port for chaining, for example. On the other hand, what are the advantages of USB 4 external SSD over Thunderbolt 5? First, better compatibility across devices. USB 4 is backwards compatible with USB 3, USB 2, and Thunderbolt 3 in most cases, making it more universally usable across PCs, Macs, and many other devices. Thunderbolt 5 requires Thunderbolt support on the host device to unlock full performance. On non-Thunderbolt devices, it may fall back to slower USB modes or not work at all. Second, lower cost. USB 4 SSDs and enclosures are typically cheaper than Thunderbolt 5 counterparts. Thunderbolt 5 requires stricter certification and more expensive components, which raises the overall price. Third, lower power requirements. USB 4 devices often use less power, which is beneficial for battery-powered setups like laptops or tablets. Thunderbolt 5 can support power-hungry devices, but the SSD itself may not need that bandwidth or power. 4. Good enough speed for most use cases. USB 4 version 2.0 supports up to 80 gigabits per second, which is comparable to early Thunderbolt 5 implementations. Most consumer SSDs can't fully saturate even the USB 4 version 1.0, the 40 gigabits per second. So in practice, real-world performance may be similar for many use cases. Number 5. Easier to find on non-high-end laptops. Many laptops support USB 4, but not Thunderbolt 5, especially AMD-based laptops or lower-cost Intel machines. Unfortunately, there are not many computers with Thunderbolt 5 yet on the market. Of course, we have the Apple Silicon Pro chips like the M4 Pro in MacBook Pro and Mac Mini, and the M4 Max and M3 Ultra in Mac Studio. But in the PC realm, only two notebooks, to my knowledge, ship with Thunderbolt 5 controller. The Razer Blade 18 and the Main Gear ML17. Only two! Same applies to accessories. There is very few Thunderbolt 5 discs on the market. The Sabrent Rocket Extreme 5, Lessie Pro 5, or OWC's Envoy Ultra Thunderbolt 5 SSD. But all of them are very expensive. Essentially, don't invest in Thunderbolt 5 accessories until you have a Thunderbolt 5 laptop or desktop. There is simply no advantage to it. But even if you have Thunderbolt 5 in your computer, the USB 4 external SSD is for majority of people the way to go. And now, let me show you the disk which I personally chose. What's included? Installation on a Mac and testing results. And later I will show you why is this so great value and good idea to get over the disks I mentioned earlier. So, the winner of my hunt for ideal external drive is the GiGimundo G40 USB 4 portable SSD. In the package, we have some paperwork, USB-C cable with attached adapter to USB-A, and beautifully looking SSD in CNC machined aluminium case, crafted from high-quality CNC machined aluminium. It's lightweight, rugged design, sturdy construction, resistant to wear and tear, and protects the GiGimundo G40 SSD from drops and scratches while staying stylish and professional. Looks like a lifelong companion to the Silver Mac Mini or Mac Studio. Firstly, let's check the speed of the internal SSD in this Mac Mini M4 to have a reference point. Okay, so the internal disk on my Mac Mini M4 here, it has roughly 1660 megabytes per second writes and 2696 megabytes reads. Fine, perfect. Now let's connect the GiGimundo drive and see what this one can achieve. So, let's plug it to the back. It's gonna appear on your desktop immediately because it's formatted for the Windows and Mac together. But first, I personally prefer to format it to my macOS only use. So, we will do that by starting disk utility, choosing the disk itself, and erase. And I will call it the same, so GCM. And format APFS and partition scheme GUID. So let's format it. Perfect. So now let's change the disk and let's see what the GiGimundo can do. Whoa, that's significantly faster. So 3069 megabytes per second writes and 2941 megabytes per second reads. Let's do it one more time. That's even better. And now, let's get to the best part, and that's why I think the GiGimundo G40 external SSD is such a great idea to get. I have an idea. What if I'll combine two of these GiGimundo G40 drives and create a huge and super fast SSD array? Will it work? Is it gonna be even faster? Can I break the USB 4-speed barrier? Let me show that right now. So look, I have here one more SSD. Exactly same model. And I will now connect it to the back next to the previous one. Fine, so two GiGimundo drives are now connected. Let's open this utility and create the RAID array. RAID assistant. Yes, I want to have Stripe. Let's select these two drives. And it's GiGimundo. Array, APFS file format, let's keep the chunk size as is. Play with this value yourself, but in general, if you are using a lot of big files, like for example, video editing files, you will benefit from higher chunk size. If you will be using bunch of dozens of super small files, you will have better results with a smaller chunk size. I will keep for now the 32 and let's see what's gonna happen. So, let's see what results can we get now. GiGimundo array. And let's see now. Oh, 6,100 megabytes per second and almost 5,700 reads. One more time. 6,100 megabytes per second reads versus 5,700 megabytes per second reads. Oh my lord, that's amazing. Is there any difference in speeds when connecting this external GiGimundo G40 SSD to Thunderbolt 4 port versus Thunderbolt 5 port? Thanks God, I have the M4 Pro version, so it has Thunderbolt 5 ports on the back. So let's see the results connected to the Thunderbolt 5 over the Thunderbolt 4, okay? Holy smokes! 6,600 megabytes per second writes and 6,200 megabytes per second reads. So this GiGimundo USB 4 array outperforms in speed even all of those fancy expensive Thunderbolt 5 drives. I have here the 2 terabyte version, which is just $188 at this moment. But if you would get the 4 terabyte version, the price per terabyte is even better. The 4 terabyte for just $307. Now, combine them into the stripe rate array as I showed you a few minutes ago, and you would get super fast 8 terabyte external SSD storage. So 2 4 terabyte GiGimundo USB 4 SSDs for a total of $614 will give you 8 terabytes of storage with Thunderbolt 5 speeds, while the fancy Thunderbolt 5 Sabrent Rocket or OWC's Envoy Ultra Thunderbolt 5 SSD for the same price, around $600, will give you in fact the same speed, so no speed benefit here, but just half the capacity. So only 4 terabyte versus the 8 terabyte in favor of the GiGimundo. If you would want the Thunderbolt 5 8 terabyte version of the Sabrent or OWC storage, you are out of luck completely, because they don't do an 8 terabyte version at all. You would have to buy some adapter and their bare 8 terabyte NVMe disk, but it would cost you double the price of the GiGimundo. $1,200 for the NVMe disk itself, for same speed and same capacity, plus $210 for the Thunderbolt adapter, so $1,410 overall. So don't waste money here. And now, just for fun, do you know how much it would cost me to upgrade my Mac Mini to 8 TB internal storage if I would buy it directly from Apple? Hold tight! $2,400. That's exactly 4 times more than you would pay for the solution I showed you in this video. So 8 terabyte GiGimundo storage with speeds over 6 gigabytes per second for just $600, while the competition can offer for the same price, same speed, but only half the capacity. That's no brainer for me. Link to all the gear I was talking about you can find right now in this video description down below. Check it yourself. And don't forget, if you would have any problems with your computer or need a consultation, you can schedule a Zoom video call with me and remote session so I can fix your computer in real time. Link is in this video description. And if you got something out of this video, feel free to subscribe and enable all notifications so the next time I upload, you'll know about it. If you made it so far, then you will be interested in this video here. So, what do you think is the best external SSD for Mac or PC? Let me know your experience down in comment section below. And see you in the next one. Bye-bye, take care.